easily the most powerful but hard to understand CODA formula is called For Each. I'm going to show you how to use it and start using it in your docs right now. Here we go. All right, so For Each, first of all, what it does is it takes a list, so it always applies on lists, and then it applies a set formula to each item in the list. So we're gonna take a look at an example here, a few more complicated examples, and then at the end, I'm gonna show you how you actually might use this in your docs. But it's important to understand at a fundamental level how this formula actually works to start with. So first, here we have a list of numbers, right? List 1, 2, 3, 4. So what it does is it takes a list like this and applies a formula to each piece. So right here, I'm saying, hey, add 3 to each number. And you'll see that the output is 4, 5, 6, 7. Or I could say, go ahead and subtract 3 from each number, or subtract 4 from each number, or 5 from each number, right? So what Formula Map is doing there is it's taking this list and just simply adding those. Let's go away from numbers though and look a little bit more advanced. We're gonna take For Each, and now we have a list of states, right? Alaska, Alabama, Arkansas, and Arizona. I'm gonna run a For Each loop on each one to do something. I ran a For Each loop here to make them all uppercase. You see, list of states for each, current value, uppercase. We're gonna look at what current value means in just a sec, so stick with us. You can make them lowercase. List of states for each, current value dot lower. In this one, you'll actually notice something different. You'll notice a different formula called Formula Map. Formula Map is actually the exact same formula. CODA created Formula Map first. They realized that it was hard to understand, like it didn't really make sense with what it did to the average person. And so they later created a new formula called For Each. They do the exact same thing. Use whichever one works for you, right? So here we go, same thing, list of states, Formula Map. Find out which ones start with ALA. True, true, false, false, right? It runs a list on every single thing. So I know that might not seem useful right now. You're like, when am I ever going to actually make a bunch of words uppercase, right? You probably won't, but For Each is extremely powerful, and I'm gonna show you next how it actually can be used in your documents. Before we do that, we got one more thing, current value. If you don't understand this, you're not gonna be able to use the formula. So, let's look at this. The phrase current value has a special meaning within a for each loop. It's used to access the current value within the list during a loop. So if we just took the list 1, 2, 3, 4, because it has 4 items, our loop will run 4 times. So the first time it runs, the current value is 1. The second time it runs, the current value is 2. The third time it runs, the current value is 3. Right, so as we see that, it's just referring to, hey, if I have a 5-item list, For Each is gonna run 5 times, and the current value is just where it's at in the list and that item. We're gonna jump right now though to an actual use case in CODA, and you'll see a lot more what I mean by this. All right, so here what we have is a table of features. So we're setting the scene, you've got a product team developing a product and they wanna develop new features. These are pretend CODA ones, AI made these up. I have no insight into what's going on. So let's say that CODA was gonna update their document permissions, right? There's certain templated steps that they wanna go through. So they say every time we wanna launch something new, we are going to conduct market research, then we'll develop our product map, then we'll design a user interface, then we'll develop an MVP, then we'll test it with users, right? So these are similar steps that they wanna do every time they launch a new product. This button is gonna help automate using For Each that workflow. So for example, let's say with document permissions, they come here and they wanna create their steps. This create steps button is gonna use a For Each loop, add these 15 rows here in just one click of a button. So I'm gonna show you now how we did that and why that worked. So let's go into this button and look at its formula. Call options. So right now it's looping, the list that For Each is looping over is a table. So a table is actually a list, right? As we look at a table, what it is a list of rows, right? So we can loop over tables and do things with them. So we're saying, hey, go take the template task table. And for each row in there, I want you to do something unique. I want you to add a row to a different table with these values in there. So because there are 15 steps here, 15, there are 15 rows that are added, right? So I can go to my mobile app and I can create my steps, my normal product market steps, boom. using for each immediately to do that. So that's just one way that for each is extremely powerful. Let me know how you're using it in your docs, or if you have questions about it, in the comments below. All right, adios.